calls when my boyfriend's ex-boyfriend walked in and I was naked and the only thing I had to cover my modesty was a nearby Bible. You know, no one answered my calls when a guy suggested that we use Lurpak instead of lube. You know, and his reasoning being that it was spreadable. I'm not spreadable. And I know it's really rich to call those buttery situations relationships. It's like calling Danny Minogue a singer. But I don't have relationships. I have what my best friend called a stressful 3 weeks. That's what happens when you're a slut, you know. You find the wrong men, don't you? But at least there's a variety, and I'm not just one person making me sob over the phone, because the truth is, isn't it all? We don't give a shit, do we? We just do the shoulder to cry on. We're not interested. As long as we're happy, it really, 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 really doesn't matter. I've not been doing stand-up that long, but I think I've come up with an idea to make it even funnier. Yeah, I really do. So I've got this idea, and I think what we should do is every time you tell a joke or like an anecdote, the MC should come on and he should re-explain what has happened so you all get it, and then we move on to the next ones. Now you're looking at me like that's not fucking funny at all. So why do so many people watch Match of the Day? So if you haven't seen Match of the Day, which you probably have, Match of the Day is a program that follows a program which has predictions before it has started, okay? And then you're into Act One, where the players play, and there's people in a room telling you what's happening in case you're not quite sure. There's people on the pitch telling you how that goal looked from Russia. Like, we don't care. We're really not interested. Then there's the interval, where they talk about what happened in Act One. Then there's Act Two, then the commentary, then the reflection. Then there's fucking Match of the Day, which tells you what you've just seen, and then about matches you weren't even interested in watching in the first place. Like, I don't understand, and I'm not being funny, they movie standards for this shit. If you meet you this dying of cancer, I don't care if Woking scored 3-1, I really, really, really don't. So I think what we've established today is, I'm not well. I don't like my job. I don't like my friends. I don't like sport. I actually think I've got a better idea for stand-up comedy. So on that note, I thank you and I say goodbye. So thank you very much.